Too many open trap, I guess I will keberatan kalau saya present dalam bahasa Inggris atau bahasa Indonesia? Lebih prefer kemana? Indonesian or English? Okay. Binhan and Henris?
Yumbin.
Should I present in English or Indonesian bahasa?
Okay.
I will share about using Ansible with Ubuntu WSL. For your information, I didn't affiliate with Microsoft, I didn't affiliate with Windows, but I use Microsoft product. It's called WSL. Let me introduce myself. I'm part of Dropsuite family as a DevOps engineer, part of OpenSUSE project and part of OpenSUSE ID community. But I don't want to discuss about the two in the right. Now we here talking about Ubuntu and WSL. So anyone here doing some automation for deployment or anything, or just doing manually?
Automation.
So why automation? We have everything you can must be automated, like provisioning, configuration management, continuous delivery, application deployment, and security compliance. Why automation? Because we can do anything with automation is repeatedly. Yes, someone out there, I don't know who is. Maybe why automation? We don't need automation. We only had a few servers, few configuration manager. We not don't need. No. We have to all. We have to automate it all. So one of two for configuration management is called Ansible. Why? It's radically simple IT automation platform. It's only simple. And support configuration management for server, application deployment, continuous testing, and already installed application, provisioning, orchestration, etc. Okay, next. Why Ansible? We can compare with script, bash or etc. In bash or etc, in script, we need coding skill, maintenance, and time. Past time in it's about 7 or 8 years ago, I create some script to deploy application to my server. But after I use Ansible, I think it's simple, powerful, and agentless. So I don't need any agent in the target servers. But in script, maybe we need some agent servers. Some agents that install in server. I mean that. Now, we talk about WSL. I don't talk many much about Ansible, but we can discuss about why WSL. So, literally, WSL is a service that enable you run Linux distribution on Windows. For the past time, we use virtual machines like VMware's workstation or maybe some of you use VirtualBox or anything, but it's very difficult to manage. Literally, it's two different machines, both host and guest, or maybe some of us use dual booting with Windows or with Linux distribution, but right now I don't. Actually, I rarely use Windows for work or for project anything. And the WSL is give an alternative that we can run both Linux and Windows seamlessly by integrating Windows and Linux with much smaller resource footprint, requiring fewer resource, memory, storage compared to traditional operating system. So initially launched in 2016 in Windows 10 version 16.07. In 2019, WSL2 was announced and introduced important change to WSL architecture. So why WSL? Anyone here use WSL? Yes, I know. No, I won't judge anyone who use WSL because it's another solving problem, another it's good. So I won't judge. Why you use WSL? Use Linux native instead? No, I don't like that. I don't like that. So, if someone here use Ubuntu, oh, it's okay. Someone here use Arch, it's okay. I don't make it as a problem because we found this WSL. So, basically, it's running two operating system. One is Windows as host, and another is Linux distribution as guest. So, and the result with smaller, it designed for development, but it's great for CI/CD pipeline. So, also can be used in business enterprise setting with create the two ability to create and distribute WSL image to machine using use in your company. Okay, interestingly, if we read the documentation of Ansible, so actually Ansible can only manage Windows host, but it cannot run on Windows host natively. So, is there anyone here question? Why don't we use shell to run Ansible in Windows? There is the answer. So, natively Ansible don't support Windows. Yeah, but it can run under the Windows subsystem for Linux WSL. Okay, any question here? No question? Oke. To configure Ansible in WSL is not very different from Linux natively. If we use Ubuntu or Debian based distribution, just install software properties common and add properties for PPA. PPA it's like support system or repository for
personal
packages. Yes, thank you for this. Then we can install Ansible. That's it. The configuration, first we can use the Ansible default location in etc Ansible or everywhere where you want.
Sorry.
Yes.
You got any specific reason to use PPA instead of using original? I mean, you search in the worst repository. Just like previously.
Wait.
I mean, instead of using PPA, I mean that you want any other one.
Yes.
Any specific reason you use PPA Ansible instead of using the universe package?
Okay. I mean in PPA Ansible it's latest version. Yes.
I don't want to. Yes. So you want the latest.
Yes. Actually we can use the universe repository, but the PPA is the latest version, latest stable version. I mean that. And the configuration, the writer use the default location in etc Ansible. I prefer to use in Ansible folder under my home folder of my user folder because it's much more easily to manage. So what we need is only inventory, playbook pad, and role pad. The other is optional. So we can use hierarchy like this. Drupal's playbook. Playbook in under playbook is we can use. We can set the Ansible playbook in here, and there is template if you need some files to put in the target server. In roles is many configuration. There is default, task, template, and path. There is role is we can use many roles as LVF. Role is to deploy so many Ansible playbook. If we run playbook, we only running one playbook. But with role, we running more playbook stimulus berkelanjutan. That's what I mean. Any demo, maybe I can show you some demonstration like this. There is in my virtual box, there is two virtual machine. Maybe it's better to take a seat. So in this I can show you this web power shell. Okay. Yes, first I'll show you about the configuration of my machine. Usually I create sub configuration in SSH. We need hostname, port, user, and identity file so Ansible can work perfectly. Wait.
Do you want to
jump in? Yes. I need to configure my text. For profile.
Appearance.
Lanjut application. Gira account tab this appearance. Ah, font size. Nah, it's good. Yeah, I'm sorry for inconvenience. I repeat, for Ansible we use SSH remote access. So only we need user, hostname is IP address or DNS name. Identity file-nya is we need this because we need SSH without password. So the example here. We know that the server is online. How we know? We can use Ansible command. Nah, sorry. Nah, I have Ansible config and Ansible host. So this is the inventory. This is the configuration, and this is the playbook. I have so many playbook, but I will use, for example, to deploy Docker to my server in the server. Wait. I need the internet working here. Wait, I'll check it first. Okay, it's working. No, it's not working. Okay, it's working. So I want run this Docker deploy Ubuntu for both my demo Ansible server. I only use this command, simple command, Ansible, because I need to run playbook. Min e it's dash i is for inventory is host. And we can use the playbook command, and I always use verbose mode, absolutely verbose mode. Oh, what, there is an error. Oh yes, I forgot something. So because the okay, I'll give you the example. maybe little. Color view. Okay, maybe I will use terminal. Now is the example of the playbook. So we had to parsing the hostname, become user is, we have to become root user, and the command is. For example, we have to update the repository, install dependency, add Docker repository, and working the distribution, and add Docker repository, update again, installing Docker package, then use systemd to use the Docker service. Then the atlas we add the Ansible SSH user to use Docker without root permission. Okay, we come back to this. I guess I forget to parsing the hostname. Okay, just running. Now it's running by itself. For your information, for next question, I have two Telkomsel data only for Central Java citizen. Any citizen of Central Java here?
Yes.
Okay. I'm sorry, I just get the data for Central Java citizen. Or maybe the other audience, if you get this, you can sell. You can sell it to your Java citizen. Central Java citizen. I want to know, is there any student here? Yeah, student. Already work in some place?
Yes.
Or as developer, anyone here as developer, software engineer? Okay, it's okay. Oh, there's fail. Yeah. Oh yeah, you can use the documentation of Ansible. It's very completed here. Offending line with 62. If we can retry this, I don't know, I don't touch that script almost 2 years. Okay, maybe I disable this. It should work better. Any question?
From what I know and what I experience. I think I've used Zulu before as a deployment tools in the server. So
yes.
What I want to ask is it like this? In WSL, is it like you deploy it using in WSL to deploy to the server? Like use command line to deploy to the server, or like to manage the software inside the WSL itself?
For your information, Ansible is not infrastructure as code as I know, but it's configuration management. So we can use wherever your server, you keep your server like AWS, GCP, Azure, Alibaba, it's no matter. So if you want to use Ansible, you can manage all the server in cross provider. So we've done. Maybe I'll need to touch my script again. Maybe we can get it. Disconnected. Here, Docker version. Now. There is Docker inside here. Or status Docker. Okay, it's good, it's running, but because the something wrong with my playbook, I cannot add my user as di Docker user group to Docker user group. Okay, it's running. So any question here again?
Yeah. Can I use Ansible for multi if I have several distro like Fedora and then Ubuntu, can I use a single playbook Ansible to manage?
Yes, but it can use like that.
With the same code, or I need to modify something?
Yes, you can use to with same code. For example, for my like this. I can deploy my node exporter for Prometheus for Ubuntu, for CentOS, for Red Hat, anything, because I don't use the package manager. For example, it's only one code. So I download the node exporter, put it somewhere in the server, maybe the folder usr local bin, and put the systemd file, running systemd, the application is run, for example like this. But for with package manager, we can use the criteria about what will run if the distribution is Ubuntu, they will run the line use Ubuntu. Like that. Good question. Okay, I can give this for you.
be refer the Ansible if there is an error?
We can use. I have the playbook to refer the configuration, but I can show you here because it's confidential.
So we need to create a new Ansible to do the refer if there is an error.
Yes. Yes, you can. That's a good question. This one. I'm sorry, the first one.
Well, I'm not in Central Java, so I think it's fine.
Sure, not about this?
I mean, like, yeah, I'm not in Central Java. Yeah.
Okay, yes.
I think my question is similar with so is Ansible can run on something based or just like Xamarin based on it? And then is Ansible configuration management and it has a desired state or if we had a configuration file before? So I think kalau di configuration manager-nya itu kita udah ngasih state change gitu. Tapi kita ubah secara langsung di server yang dulu itu, apakah dia tetap ikut konfigurasinya Ansible apa langsung di servernya itu?
Waktu di server yang dituju, maksudnya mau merubah konfigurasi di server yang dituju?
Ya, tapi sebelumnya itu udah ke konfigurasi di Ansible yang dituju.
Oh iya, langsung dari Ansible-nya ini langsung di konfigurasi pakai konfigurasi yang baru di server.
Oh, iya. Itu dia bakal ngikutin yang mana ya?
Yang dari yang baru, yang dari yang baru, yang kita report dari Ansible. Okay. Any question?
I usually before running Ansible Blink, I add some comment to debugging or testing the playbook by adding dash syntax check. Do you have any method or comment to debugging the playbook?
Debugging the playbook, I only use this. Now when I run the Ansible with debugging, I use this. We can use dash p. Actually, is p for p is very verbose. So whatever you do, whatever it show in the screen. Okay, two good question. I only have one data package. No, you don't get it.
I've read something. If you guys want to learn more about Ansible, there's a good author there and he's also one of the maintainer of Ansible Galaxy, Jeff Gerling. Gerling guy, YouTube. If you guys watch it on YouTube, he's very active to contribute in Ansible.
Okay, thank you for your information, Tony. Tony is right. I follow Jeff Gerling too in YouTube. The account is Gerling Guy and the GitHub. His GitHub is also Gerling Guy. He is one of our Ansible author and his contribution is very good. So many contribution. Okay, another question. Okay, anyone who want this package? Okay, I will give it to anyone if he can or someone can answer my question. You can use your phone, your your laptop if connected to internet. There is Ansible manager, Ansible. Don't answer it. So it's like graphical user interface for Ansible. Maybe anyone in here can answer it. What is the name? I mean the open source version. It's from Ansible. We have two product in Ansible for graphical user interface. One is paid version, one is open source version. So who know is the name of the open source version? You can use your phone, you can use your anything. At least it's connected to internet. Yeah?
Semaphore.
Huh? No, not semaphore. Yes. No, it's paid version. Ansible Tower is paid version. I mean it's open source version.
It's M with X.
Huh?
It's M with X.
Yes. It's A with X. That you cannot get this. You answer it.
I can answer
with
this.
3 alphabet. First one is A. Last one is X.
AWX.
But you wrong first. Okay, I change the question. What is collection of playbook that hosting in Ansible? Collection of playbook and roles. Same with namanya sama dengan yang alam semesta with universe.
Ansible.
Ah, that's right. Okay. I would like to thank for our sponsor. But yes, demo ya. Okay, before thank you slide. As Dropsuit representative, I announced that we are hiring. What is of your open position? It's senior software engineer and quality assurance engineer. Chip. So what we offer, competitive compensation, long time incentive like stocks, anything else. Hybrid working model is for senior, but for quality we on-site in Bandung. Growth opportunities, and we are working as a global company. So my team is, one is in Indonesia, one is in US, another one is in India. Okay. Basically we communicate with English. Okay, thank you to our platinum sponsor, LibreOffice, Canonical Ubuntu, our server, OnlyOffice, IndoBSD, my friend from Ubuntu Korea. And special thanks for Dropsuit for allow me to be a speaker in here and support you as a speaker in here. Thank you very much. Thank you for your attending. See you next time in another event. I hope I will attend the another event as a speaker again. Thank you.